Hello students, today we'll discuss about the divisibility test of very important number, which is 11 and 7. In my previous video, I have talked about the divisibility test of the numbers 2, 5 and 10, in which we were only seeing the ones place of a number. In the case of 2, it has to be 2, 4, 6, 8, 0. In the case of 5, the ones place should be having 0 or 5. And for the divisibility rule of 10, it should be having 0 at the ones place. Okay, so these are connected. Then we also discussed about the divisibility rule of 3 and 9, where we have to sum up the digits. Sum up the digits of the given number. And then, if you sum up the digits of the given number, which is divisible by 3 or 9, then the whole number is divisible by 3 and 9. This we had done earlier. Okay. Now, after 3 and 9, we also discussed the divisibility rule by 4 and by 8, which is quite related, in which we are studying the number formed by the last two digits of a given number. Like for example, if I have 5 and 12, then the number formed by the last two digits is 12. So if 12 is a multiple of 4, then 512 is a multiple of 4. Same happens for 8, in which we study the number formed by the last three digits. But if the number has only last three digits, then of course we'll take the whole number for division in the divisibility rule. Okay, now to continue with a new topic, which is the divisibility rule of 11 and which is very, very, very important for the 6th standard, is a number is divisible by 11 if the difference between the sum of the digits at odd places and sum of the digits at even places is 0 or any multiple of 11, then the number is divisible by 11. Now I can make out that just by writing this, it's not clear. So we'll take up an example for the clarity of the concept. Like for example, I take a small number first, 10824. Okay. Now I start marking the odd places and the even places in the number. Like this is my ones place. So ones place is always marked as odd place. After odd, you will mark this as even place. After even, odd place, then even place, then odd place. Iske andar bachcho, odd place ka matlab 8 to hamara even number hota hai. Lekin jis jagah pe 8 rakha hai, wo third jagah pe rakha hai. तो इस नंबर का प्लेस ऑड है, नंबर ऑड नहीं है, ठीक है? तो आप ऑड से शुरू करेंगे, ऑड इवन ऑड, ठीक है? ये क्लियर हो गया कैसे मार्क करना है? Now we find the sum of digits at odd places. जो जो डिजिट हमारे ऑड प्लेस के नीचे लिखे हैं, उनको लिख के ऐड करना है, जैसे 4, 8 और 1. अब इसको हम ऐड करेंगे, 8 plus 4, 12, 12 plus 1, 13. ये तो एक चीज आ गई. Now we will find the sum of the digits at even places. Okay. Now for even places, what numbers we will take? 2 plus 0, which is 2. तो हमारे पास दो नंबर आ गए. अब हम इन दो नंबरों का डिफरेंस निकालेंगे. डिफरेंस मतलब सब्ट्रैक्ट करेंगे और बड़े वाले नंबर पहले लिखेंगे, छोटे वाला नंबर उसके पीछे लिखेंगे. 13 - 12 पॉजिटिव सब्ट्रैक्शन करेंगे 11. तो ये जो रिजल्टिंग नंबर है अगर ये 11 के टेबल में आता है या ये जीरो हो जाता है, दोनों में से एक चीज, तो ये नंबर पूरा डिविजिबल है. सो एज 11 इज डिविजिबल बाय 11, देयरफॉर 10824 इज डिविजिबल बाय 11. है ना इंटरेस्टिंग? ओके, सो नाउ वील टेक वन मोर एग्जाम्पल फॉर द क्लैरिटी ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट, विच इज, अब लंबा नंबर ले लेते हैं, 7016930 8. ठीक है, सो नाउ वॉट वील डू, वील स्टार्ट मार्किंग इट्स प्लेस. ऑड, इवन, ऑड, इवन, ऑड, इवन, ऑड, इवन. नीचे डिजिट कुछ भी आ रहा हो, ऑड नंबर आए कि इवन नंबर आए, आप उनकी जगहों को ऑड इवन मार्क करेंगे. ठीक है, नाउ अगेन यू फाइंड द सम ऑफ द डिजिट्स एट ऑड प्लेसेस. 8 + 3 + 6 + 0. यू कैन यूज योर फिंगर सो दैट यू डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज व्हाट नंबर आर यू राइटिंग. ओके, 8 + 3 = 11, 11 + 6 = 17. सो नाउ सम ऑफ डिजिट्स एट इवन प्लेसेस 0, 0 + 9 + 1 + 7. 9 + 1 = 10, 17. Wow, I'm getting same numbers. Okay, so now I find the difference. 17, this difference, this one and this one. 17 - 17, I get 0. 0, I get, so 0 is divisible by 11, which shows, therefore, 7016930 8 is also divisible by 11. Clear, children? Okay. Now, the divisibility rule of 7, which is normally not used, but for competitive classes, it's always good to use the divisibility rule of 11. Now, by 7, if you want to check, it says, a number is divisible by 7 if the number obtained by twicing the digit at once place and then subtracting it from the left out number, you get a multiple of 7. So the number is divisible by 7. For example, I take 343. What is the digit at the ones place? It is 3. I will twice the digit. So 3 × 2 = 6. Now, this number 6 is to be subtracted from the rest of the number. So if I delete 3 from the number, I get 34 left over. And then I subtract 6 from it. Now you subtract. This is 14, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. You get 8 and this is 2, 28. So now 28 is divisible by 7. So therefore 343 is divisible by 7. Obviously, this rule applies to a number which is 3 digit, not a 2 digit, because 2 digit you will be able to divide and see. Okay, so now briefly I'll explain what I have done. We have discussed the divisibility rule of 2, 5, 10, 3, 9, 4 and 8 in the previous video. And in this video, we have discussed the divisibility rule of 11 and 7. So now, in the next video, I will be discussing the exercise 3.3 of Chapter 3, Class 6, Maths. For more videos and study material, please refer to our website www.studiestoday.com and also subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.